the Lake Michigan Consortium Winter Webinar Series. Over the next few months, we will be presenting webinars on a variety of topics pertaining to the Clean Cities mission. The webinars will be recorded and will be available on our website. All attendees are in listen-only mode. If you have a question, please type your question in and it will be answered at the conclusion of our presentation. The Lake Michigan Consortium was developed in an effort to provide a regional approach to the Clean Cities mission. We strive through this partnership to provide innovative and sustainable practices to address the issues which face our region. I am Lorrie Lisek, Executive Director for Wisconsin Clean Cities. Joining me on the webinar today is Samantha Bingham, Clean Transportation Program Director for the Chicago Department of Transportation and the Chicago Area Clean Cities Coordinator. Also presenting today is Carl Lisek, Executive Director of South Shore Clean Cities in Northern Indiana. The focus of today's webinar is to introduce our coalitions and our collaborative efforts. As part of the U.S. Department of Energy Clean Cities Program, we have a network of expertise that reaches across our country. As you may know, we are membership-driven organizations, and we serve as your regional contacts for all things Clean Cities related. We know there are many resources available to you in this day and age of HGTV and YouTube, and we always tend to think of DIY or do it yourself. We suggest you hit the easy button and reach out to your Clean Cities coalitions to assist in your sustainable transportation endeavors. Next slide. This is a sampling of some of the collaborative efforts we are pursuing as regional projects. We will be highlighting these efforts during this webinar. So sit back, get a cup of coffee, and see what you can learn about the Lake Michigan Consortium. And now I'll turn the presentation over to Carl and Samantha, who will discuss some of our collaborative efforts.
Well, good morning again. This is Carl Lisek, and thank you for joining us on the first of a series of webinars we are planning on hosting this year. As your Lake Michigan Clean Cities team, our goal is very simple. Collaboration, working together breeds success. One of the highlights that we wanted to talk about today was the U.S. Fuels Across America's Highways, or Michigan to Montana, or the M2M project. The U.S. Department of Energy selected Gas Technology Institute and 8 Clean Cities coalitions, as well as many other project partners, to develop and implement the Michigan to Montana corridor concept. I-94 is a primary connection between major metropolitan areas in the upper Midwest. The main goal of this project is not to install infrastructure in every gap that will be identified. It is to create the necessary team to guide the creation of an alternative fuel corridor, deploy selected stations and vehicles, and provide education, training to establish a sustainable alternative fuel and advanced vehicle market. This will allow the M2M corridor to continue growing well beyond the end of the project term. And focusing on I-94 from the international border, starting at Port Huron, Michigan, across America's heartland to Billings, Montana, critical success factors include significantly growing the availability and use of alternative fuels in advanced vehicles and markets critical for long-term success of these technologies. This project will establish community-based partnerships and provide the structure necessary to implement a successful deployment of alternative fuel stations, including electric vehicle and electric vehicle infrastructure, compressed natural gas, biofuels and propane stations, and other alternative fuel vehicles. This corridor is a key international trade route connecting the Great Lakes in the Intermountain regions, covering 1,500 miles with over 18 billion annual vehicle miles traveled. We also will be giving a more detailed update on this project and several others at the upcoming National Truck Equipment Association meeting in Indianapolis on March 8th. Watch our websites for upcoming details. At this time, I'd like to introduce Ms. Samantha Bingham from Chicago Area Clean Cities. Samantha?
Thanks, Carl. Thank you. Midwest Evolve is another project that we are collaborating on, not only as a Lake Michigan Clean Cities Consortium, but as a larger coalition of Upper Midwest coalitions to advance the adoption of electric vehicles throughout our region. So Midwest Evolve is a project that actually emerged from the coalitions collaborating on the project Carl just mentioned, I-94 corridor M2M project. In early 2017, the Department of Energy issued a call for funding applications in support of EV education. Our coalitions banded together in the Upper Midwest to respond to that call for funding applications. We as coalitions knew that there was a need in our communities for more EV education. And so we worked together on the application and were successful in receiving an award for the funding. So the Evolve program focuses on addressing the need of enhanced EV education. And we provide that education through numerous showcases throughout the 7 states that are participating in this program. We provide lunch and learns at workplaces. We do electric vehicle ride and drives. We provide EVs at key festivals and other opportunities where we're going where the people are and giving them the opportunity to learn more about an EV by interacting with us. And also when we have the availability to get them behind the wheel to test drive it themselves. So far, I'm happy to report that in 2017, we hosted a total of 138 events across the Upper Midwest and reached 36,000 people through those events. That's only year one. We've got 2 more years, so we hope to make a significant difference in the Upper Midwest in terms of EV adoption. Next slide. Great. So I'm going to cover a little bit about our coalition in the Chicago area and some regional projects that we have been working on that are regional in focus, but are opportunities for us to share our lessons learned with other coalitions in our region. One of the first things that I wanted to share was our Drive Clean Taxi program. Drive Clean Taxi is a sub-funding program out of our Drive Clean Chicago initiative. Drive Clean Chicago is funded with federal transportation dollars. In this case, we're using CMAC, Congestion Mitigation and Air Quality Funding, that is available to other regions with air quality issues. Through our Drive Clean Taxi program, we've been able to fund 90 electric rideshare and livery vehicles through a pilot project to give those drivers the opportunity to test out electric vehicles. Next slide. Through our Drive Clean Truck program, this program provides an 80% point of sale discount on electric and hybrid Class 2 through Class 8 vehicles. So this is a voucher program. It's not a grant, it's not a rebate. It's an upfront reduction in the invoice cost of a vehicle. We've been able to fund 300 vehicles through this program, which include 240 hybrid vans, trucks, and buses, and 50 all-electric vehicles. This Alpha Baking vehicle is one of the success stories that we have out of the program. Alpha Baking, who operates in all 3 of our Lake Michigan Consortium territories, they purchased 5 all-electric delivery trucks, got to experience them, got to know the benefits, and they have on order 5 more. Next slide. Another key example of a success story from Drive Clean Truck is the purchase of 10 electric buses for the Aon and Prudential Centers. These buildings run a mini transit route downtown to pick up tenants from the Metra regional train stations in the downtown area. And they replaced their diesel fleet with these 10 electric buses and thus became the largest electric bus fleet that is privately operated in North America. Next slide. I should say that while Drive Clean Truck and Drive Clean Taxi have expended all of their funding, we do have $20 million more in federal funding coming for Drive Clean Truck. Unfortunately, due to the current administration's hold on all Buy America waiver requests. We are in a stalemate at this moment and have not been able to implement the program in a timely manner. So once there's a release on the Buy America requirements for these vehicles, we will be able to proceed with the funding. The next success story I wanted to point out was the City of Chicago's electric vehicle announcement. In October, the city announced that we were going to electrify 25% of our light duty eligible fleet. That comes as a result of Clean City's intern here putting together an analysis that helped the city make that investment. Next slide. Okay, so here we have, as I mentioned, with Midwest Evolve, we've been doing these events to help people understand and ask questions about electric vehicles. This is a great example of an event that we held, and it's indicative of the events that we hold throughout the region. This is the event that we held at Jazz Fest this past summer in the city of Chicago at Millennium Park. We spoke to thousands of people over a four-day period having EVs there. I promise there are EVs in that photo. They're just surrounded by people who were interested in learning more about the vehicles. So there's absolutely a need for people to see these vehicles out in places where they are going to be and provide them this opportunity to learn more about EVs. So while we weren't able to do a ride and drive and get butts and seats at Jazz Fest, we hope to make up for that by having an electric vehicle ride and drive at the Chicago Auto Show this year. So February 10th through 19th, we will have an EV ride and drive all days of the public days of the auto show. If you are interested in participating, or if you would like to come and volunteer, you can contact me. Or you can just show up at the auto show and get an opportunity to test drive an EV. Another upcoming event for our coalition is our second annual Springfield Summit. The climate in Springfield has changed in the last couple of years in support of alternative fuels and advanced vehicle technologies. And last year, we, with our partners on the slide here, we formed the Illinois Alternative Fuels Alliance to promote alternative fuels and educate lawmakers and state staff in Springfield about the benefits to the state of Illinois but from the use of clean vehicle technologies. The event this year will be held on April 25th. More information to come. And last but not least, in terms of upcoming events, is our Lake Michigan Clean Cities Consortium Green Drives Conference and Expo. Green Drives, this will be the seventh year of the conference. It keeps growing year over year. We anticipate over 200 people to be attending. What I always say is this is a national conference quality event, but it's only a one-day investment of your time, and it's affordable to attend. It really is you can't miss it if you're in the Midwest. It's one of the largest green vehicle conferences here in our region. We have a top-notch group of experts speaking at the conference. We have 60-plus premier vendors on hand in our expo area and vehicles on display with additional vehicles available for test drives. John Davis of Motor Week fame is our MC. We have, in the past, we've had leadership from UPS, Coca-Cola, and other large corporate fleets come and speak to us about their plans for the use and implementation of alternative fuels. And we've also had numerous local fleet managers come and share their experiences and case studies with their experience with trying to reduce emissions and reduce petroleum use in their own fleets. And I guarantee we will have great weather once again this year. The event date is May 17th. And we will be opening up registration and sponsorship opportunities soon. This is a very quick snapshot of the current local funding opportunities for clean vehicle projects in Illinois. The items with the green circle are what are currently available. The other items are still on the books for the state of Illinois. However, they have not those programs have not been in operation for a couple of years, but nonetheless, they are still on the books, and we hope to see them reemerge at some point in the future. And in terms of the VW settlement, we don't have a lot of information about what the state's plans are for that funding. Next slide. So if you're interested in staying on top of what Illinois has planned for the Volkswagen Mitigation Trust, I think we are getting $108 million from the trust. You can go to the Illinois EPA's website. They are the organization that will be administering those funds. Currently, they have one web page dedicated to the Mitigation Trust Fund with information on it. But right now, all the state is saying is that they're going to have a round of public input opportunities. None of those have been announced yet, but to get that information straight from the IEPA, you can email Brad Frost, whose contact information is there, to get on the state's email list for the Volkswagen. Next slide. And another thing that our coalitions here in the Great Lakes region, the commonality that we share is our annual report. As many of you probably know, the coalitions are required to send in an annual report to the Department of Energy, and this data is used, it's so important to provide information to the Department of Energy on how successful we have been in our region in terms of reducing petroleum. This not only communicates our local success to the Department of Energy, but it also gives local and national elected officials the opportunity to know the status of the clean vehicle market across the country. So the annual reports, Wisconsin and South Shores is due February 23rd. Chicago area is due February 14th. It's a very easy, the information that we ask for is at your fingertips. All we are asking for are the total number of vehicles in your fleet, and how many of those are running on an alternative fuel or are in advanced vehicle technologies like a hybrid. We need the average miles traveled per vehicle type, and what I mean by that is, so if you operate a fleet of, if you're a municipal fleet, you probably have maybe garbage trucks, you have police vehicles, you have salt spreaders. Group those vehicles together and give us an estimate of what the average miles traveled is for that group. Then report to us how much fuel or alternative fuel they've used. And if you can provide the estimated average fuel economy for the vehicles in the fleet, and the ones that you replaced with the clean technology vehicle. As I mentioned, we do ask for the amount of fuel used, and that includes electricity. So many times we get data from fleets using EVs or plug-in hybrids, and they don't give us the electricity used. We can help you determine how you can track that. And if you don't know how to do that, please reach out to us or provide a note and we can help you with that. And we're not just collecting information on alternative fuels. So fuel economy improvements do count. So if you've right-sized a vehicle, if you've done idling reduction, if you've done vehicle miles traveled reductions, those count as well. Anything that reduces petroleum is in the Clean Cities toolbox. If you're a fuel station, we're just asking for the estimated number of vehicles you might be serving, but what's key is the total number or estimated or rounded number, if you prefer that, number of gallons of fuel or electricity dispensed, or the GGE, the gasoline gallon equivalent. And just note that there are multiple tabs on the workbook for the survey, so don't make sure you don't miss out on the additional tabs. And if you have any reason to provide additional information, or if you have questions, send us a note. Provide a note either directly in the survey or in the email that you send to us with the survey in it. Provide some additional clarification or questions that you might have, and we'll be happy to address those in the report as well. And with that, I would like to introduce and throw it back to Lorrie Lisek.
Thanks, Samantha, and thanks for sharing all that information on a lot of the collaboration that we're doing. Individually, then, as coalitions, we also have other projects that we're working on. So in addition to some of the projects that Samantha mentioned, in Wisconsin, we're also focusing on a project with Penske, in which it's a partnership with the U.S. Department of Energy. Penske is offering fleets the opportunity for an extended test drive of a compressed natural gas truck before buying or leasing. And through this program, natural gas trucks are available at the same price as a comparable diesel truck. Penske ensures a smooth rental experience providing training resources and 24/7 roadside assistance. The project, which includes CNG heavy-duty truck, is currently available in just 3 regions in the U.S. So if you operate a fleet in Wisconsin, we can provide additional information regarding this opportunity. And this program directly aligns with Wisconsin being named as a U.S. EPA SmartWay affiliate for the 7th consecutive year, working with the U.S. EPA program to introduce regional fleets to the SmartWay program. The Volkswagen settlement is being handled in Wisconsin through the Wisconsin Department of Administration. James Langdon will be administering the program for the state, and currently funds have been directed through the state budget to address transit issues and to replace state vehicles. Jim presented at our annual meeting on December 12th in Oshkosh, and he was very interested in learning about how additional funding may be addressed. There's approximately $20 million that may be addressed in the next biennium budget. So we are right now preparing a frequently asked questions guide regarding the VW settlement that will be posted on our new website. And so stay tuned for more information. And if you would like more information regarding the Volkswagen settlement, I suggest that you contact James Langdon at the Wisconsin Department of Administration. Additionally, we're finishing work on our Wisconsin Biofuels Retail Advancement in Wisconsin Transportation Project, which is called our BRAT program. And we have been working with Quick Trip, Best Convenience Stores, and United Co-op to implement over 100 E85 and or E85 and E15 pumps across Wisconsin. We've been working with the Office of Energy Innovation on this and also the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association, and funding for this program was provided through the U.S. Department of Agriculture. Watch for additional information regarding a potential opportunity as Wisconsin Clean City seeks to support an electric vehicle room at the 2018 Milwaukee Auto Show, which will be held February 24th through March 4th in Milwaukee. And Wisconsin Clean Cities will also be meeting with federal legislators at the Transportation Energy Partners Conference in Washington, D.C. on February 11th through the 14th. Finally, Wisconsin Clean Cities is seeking to jumpstart the Wisconsin Smart Fleet Program in 2018. And this is a program that was designed through a grant opportunity that we had received to assist fleets in the implementation of alternative fuels and provide recognition to participating fleets. To date, we've done assessments of over 31 fleets across the state, and that information is available on our website. And that is available so that other fleets can look and see what fleets across the state are doing. We use this too, as I mentioned, as a recognition for these fleets at our annual meeting. And we are looking for sponsorship and able to enable us to again start the Wisconsin Smart Fleet Program. So make sure to stay connected with Clean Cities through our website and through our newsletters for upcoming opportunities and events. And any questions that you have regarding Wisconsin Clean Cities, just feel free to reach out to us. I'll now turn it over to Carl, who's going to talk a little bit about South Shore Clean Cities.
Again, we just want to thank you all for being on this webinar today. Our coalitions are successful because of you and the implementation of green fuels and green activities that are going on across the Lake Michigan Consortium. So again, we thank you because our success is based on you, our stakeholders. So we're really excited about some of the opportunities, and we're calling 2018 really the year of opportunity. So we're going to be celebrating our annual meeting this year on February 20th. We anticipate over 300 fleet experts at our annual meeting in Michigan City. So please come out and support some of our award winners, hear about some of the new upcoming programs that we're developing specifically in the South Shore Clean Cities territory. And we look forward to seeing you there. Next slide, please. So our Green Fleet Program, through our partnership with the Michiana Area Council of Governments, MACOG, and the Northern Indiana Regional Planning Commission, we continue to work through a CMAC grant application to help governmental agencies reduce emissions throughout Northern Indiana. This program utilizes some of America's top technology to assist governmental and private sector fleets in developing the most efficient plans to reduce their environmental footprints, but also allows them to continue to be introduced to some of the newest technologies and safety trends. And last but not least, to keep abreast of Chicagoland, including our three-state area, we have our new radio program called the Green Fleet Radio, which aired just this past Wednesday on the local PBS station, radio 89.1 FM, and you can link to that off the South Shore Clean Cities website. So our goal really is to promote our three-state area on some of the great projects and programs that are happening and to keep you informed about these opportunities. A couple of new opportunities have currently happened. Just earlier this week, VW Electrify America is currently soliciting opportunities for the second cycle of funding. They are looking for input from stakeholders across the nation and will be hosting a webinar on Tuesday, February 1st from 2 to 3 p.m. Eastern Time. You will be able to follow the links from any of our Clean Cities sites. So go to our Clean Cities and you can register for that. And another opportunity we just wanted to make you aware of is we anticipate the US EPA DARE grant becoming available very shortly. We anticipate that US EPA will announce their national program. So if you're interested in regards to diesel emission reductions in and around the Midwest, please link again to one of our websites and you'll see the solicitation for that coming up. As we talk a little bit about the VW settlement, you can see that there is just a lot of information that is coming across the wires from various publications and various groups. Not all this information is accurate, so we would just ask you to work with your local Clean Cities Coalition to hear the most accurate information. Here in Northern Indiana, we have hosted over 10 VW mitigation educational series already with the state of Indiana. And in the state of Indiana, the Indiana Department of Environmental Management has been named as the beneficiary. So we're very excited about the opportunities to reduce NOx emissions in Northern Indiana with the VW settlement. And so we're looking for just the opportunity for you to stay engaged with our three coalitions. And as you already know, 2018 is going to be formed to be one of the busiest years of all time for not only the Clean Cities program, but for all of us in regards to reducing diesel emissions and also reducing fuel usage. So please see all of our websites. And then with that, I'd like to introduce you back to Ms. Catherine Yoder from South Shore Clean Cities.
Hello, everyone. If anybody has any questions, please put them in the question box and we will get them answered. Carl, if you want to show all the events coming up, we've got that slide there.
Sure. Again, some of our national partners are on this website. A couple of the things that we really wanted to point out to you was really the Energy Independence Summit, which is in Washington, D.C. from the weeks of February 11th through the 14th. This is one of the best ways for your organization to learn about the national programs and to meet with Clean Cities coalitions from across the nation. So this is something that we'll be hosting a webinar on next week on the 21st to learn more about that. So again, if you would link to one of our websites, you'll hear more about the upcoming Energy Independence Summit in Washington, D.C. And again, you can see just the various events that were on that. And again, if you go to our website, any of our websites, you'll see the most partnerships, all the partnerships that we have across the country, linking you to all the national events that are going on. And as we discussed earlier, your Lake Michigan Consortium will be hosting a learning event at the National Truck Equipment Association on March 8th at 1 p.m. And again, you'll be able to link about that. But you'll learn about these couple programs and some of the updates that are available. You know, as we mentioned before with the I-94 corridor project, there are still some funding mechanisms that are available. And if you're looking at potentially any type of alternative fuel implementation along the I-94 corridor, reach out to one of us and we can connect you with a request on how to potentially apply for additional funding in and along the I-94 corridor. So with that, I'd like to, again, turn it right back over to Catherine.
All right. We do have one question. What is the status of the Clean Cities funding at the national level?
We've been informed by the Department of Energy that our program, our national program, has been funded for the entire 2018 year. So we're very excited to report that, and that we can continue working with the Department of Energy and all the Clean Cities coalitions across the United States. So we're very excited about that.
Awesome, thank you. Another question is, are there any updates on EV tax credits, whether it be in Chicago, Wisconsin, or Indiana?
Sam, do you want to take that?
Sure. So it's my understanding that the federal government has and will continue to support the EV tax credits. If something were to change, we will let you know if it looks like there's going to be some sort of threat to it. You will probably hear it from the national news as well as from us. Locally, here in Illinois, we have a rebate program. It has been put on hold for several years, yet the state continues to collect the fee that funds that program. So the law that enabled the alternative fuel rebate program is still, as I mentioned, on the books here in Illinois. So we have hopes that that program will return at some point in the future.
All right. Anything from Indiana or Wisconsin as far as EV tax credits?
Well, again, I think, you know, as Sam mentioned, the national project, and that's part of our work working in Washington, D.C. with the TEP program, is that we visit with our congressmen and senators to talk about the importance of all the tax extensions with all the alternative fuels. And again, hearing from some of the national advocacy, Department of Energy, US EPA, Department of Agriculture, will all be represented at this national meeting. So that is one of the things that Wisconsin and South Shore Clean Cities participate in on an annual basis. And it's a great opportunity for you potentially to visit and attend that event also. So please look at the upcoming webinar to learn more about the Transportation Energy Partnership on January 21st.
Perfect. The final question, do you have to be a member to submit information for the annual report?
No. For any of our coalitions, you do not have to be a member. And we just encourage folks to submit their information and say if there was something that was submitted to South Shore that was for Wisconsin, we would make sure that information got into the right hands and anywhere in the country. So if it's not particular to our area, we would make sure that it would get into the right hands of the participating Clean Cities Coalition.
For the Chicago area Clean Cities, if you're in our region and you're not a member and you submit a report, we will waive the membership fee for that year. And we do that for every year that you submit an annual report and you're a fleet. We greatly value that data. So we go ahead and waive that fee for you. So you will become a member if you are in our region and give us the data.
All right. I do not see any other questions. Do any of the three of you have any final comments?
This is Sam. Yes, something that I missed during my rundown of the annual report is, if you're not a fleet, if you're in the industry or you are a fleet and you submit your report, I encourage you to ask your peers to submit a report as well, or if you're a vendor that you work with the fleets that or you contact the fleets that you work with to encourage them to submit the report. There's a lot more going on in our areas than we get data for, and we don't like to make guesses. We like to have actual data. So please, share the report widely. We'd appreciate the information.
And also in Wisconsin, we
use those numbers from our annual report for our recognition for our members at our annual stakeholder meeting. So it's great if you submit the information and you are a member, you will be recognized at our annual meeting for supporting the Clean Cities mission.
And with that, we'd just like to thank everybody for being on the webinar today, and we look forward to upcoming webinars, and you'll be getting some more emails in regards to those upcoming webinars here very shortly.
All right, thank you, everyone. As we mentioned before, this webinar has been recorded and will be up on all three of our websites if you want to visit it later on. And like they said before, if anybody has questions at any time, comments, ideas about programs, please let us know, call our offices anytime, and we appreciate you being on the webinar. With that, thank you everyone, and have a great day.
Thank you.